Hi, my name is Jayesh Joshi. I'm an artist, a musician, a motorcyclist, and a self-defense instructor. I'm 23 years old, and I just like to do whatever I have an interest in, and I try to do it the best that I have the capability of. I've been drawing since I was 2 years old, but the first drawing that I did, I don't clearly remember what it was. But the drawing that I do remember, the youngest drawing that I do remember, was this pencil sketch, no, a color pencil and sketch pen drawing of my father making momos for the family. So he's wearing like this bib that says, "I am the cook," or "Kiss the cook," or something. And he's just making momos. So that was the first drawing that I remember. When I was a kid, I used to play a lot of sports. I was very much into cricket. Then I switched to football when I turned 13, 14, and I came to Gurgaon. Actually, I got a lot of time to draw. I used to draw in school. I used to draw after school, before playing, after playing. I mean, it was just a very, very comforting outlet for me to just get into. I could draw like for hours, and there was nothing that was stopping me as such. And I was never really one that was, you know, into copying images. Now I do take references from different images and different models and different faces, but my whole basis of conceptualizing as a kid, as somebody that was learning how to draw, has always been wo sab mere andar se hi aata tha, it wasn't external. I used to argue with my art teacher also, but yeah, jo bhi hai, it's pretty good now, because conceptual knowledge has become really strong. I started following other artists when I was about 14, I think. Before that, I used to look at a lot of art. I used to read a lot of comics. I used to read a lot of, just picture books, trying to get, matlab ki is art ka kya scope hai? Matlab kya kya kar sakte? Art ka koi scope nahi hai. Matlab there's no limit to what you can do as a visual artist. But wahi tha ki like baaki log kya kar rahe hain. और उस टाइम नहीं था कि बाकी लोग क्या करें, उस टाइम बस ये था कि हाँ, दिस इज़ अ कूल इमेज, सो लेट्स ट्राई टू यू नो अंडरस्टैंड कि ये बनी कैसे होगी एंड ऑल दैट. तो 14 की एज पे आई स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग अबाउट आर्ट लाइक मोर प्रोफेशनली. उससे पहले भी मुझे आर्ट ही करना था. आई वॉज नेवर समबडी दैट वॉज लाइक कि मुझे बड़ा होकर पुलिस ऑफिसर बनना है या फिर इंजीनियर बनना है या ये बनना है वो बनना है. मुझे हमेशा आर्ट से रिलेटेड कुछ करना था, बट यही था कि आर्ट में मुझे मालूम ही नहीं था कि क्या क्या कर सकते हो. तो व्हेन आई वाज आई थिंक 11 और 12, आई वांटेड टू बी अ कॉमिक आर्टिस्ट. आई वांटेड टू यू नो जॉइन, आई यूज्ड टू थिंक मार्वल वाज अ कॉमिक बुक, बट मार्वल इज़ जस्ट अ स्टोरी हब एंड दैट्स वेयर द स्टोरीज कम फ्रॉम. तो मेरे को कॉमिक्स बनानी थी. आई वांटेड टू ड्रॉ स्पाइडरमैन, सुपरमैन, ऑल ऑफ दोज. देन व्हेन आई बिकेम 14 ईयर्स ओल्ड, आई वांटेड टू बिकम एन एनिमेटर. दैट वाज द लॉन्गेस्ट फेज इन माय लाइफ. फ्रॉम 14 टू ऑलमोस्ट 19 years, I just wanted to animate. Then I realized that there's more in animation. I mean, you could be, you could be a visual developer, somebody that paints the worlds. So it's like, ki, agar aap Aladdin ki story bana rahe ho, to what does Aladdin wear? What does he look like? More artistic than technical. Not painting every frame or drawing every frame to understand how Aladdin walks, but more behind it, ki Aladdin hai kaun and what does he do and all of that. And after that, I just decided that I do not want to get into like the animation world also, because it's a little bit too organized for my liking. I am an organized person, but it's just like ki art, I feel, is something that has to be organic. Now I feel like these days, a lot of people are just minting money by publishing films or publishing art and all of that, and I wanted to steer a little bit away from that. I wanted to make money from my art, but I also wanted to look at, you know, what I can do as an artist. Like, how can I put myself out in the world just by making art and not by making somebody else's idea into a reality, which is what a job would be, which is why I choose to be a freelancer now and not have a studio-based job, because it's just like, what's the point in working for a boss who's also thinking the ideas? And it's like he, your ideas could be better. But so professionally, I've been thinking about art forever. But it caught more of a direction after I got into college. That was like 18, 19 years old. So the art style that I've chosen to go ahead with started developing when I was about 20, 21 years old. I got into nudity for a very simple reason. I got into nudity because I wanted to explore the female form. I've been drawing men all my life. Superman, Batman. Like I said, my background was always like, you know, male superheroes. And the only reason why I got into nudity, and that too of the female, was because I wanted to look at, you know, how the body works. A lot of people have credited me to be somebody that has accelerated that in their heads, that I'm not trying to bring about a change because I don't think it needs change. I realize that there's some taboo around nudity, the female form, and just being naked in general, but it's like I am just exploring it. Jo mujhe karna hai, wo kar raha hu. I'm not doing it for people. But now it's like you don't want to be in a place that's too crowded. I find myself not being able to think in a place that's too crowded, and now this whole sphere of nudity has become a little bit too crowded. So I'm working on my last series right now, which is around nudity. I used to enjoy making my own stuff more, but the past couple of years I've been finding myself enjoying gigs more, like freelance opportunities more. It's just that the whole idea of, you know, translating somebody else's concept into a reality, a visual reality, is something that I've started really enjoying now. The problems that I faced are quite a few. There's like in any other profession, I mean, there's always going to be issues that you face and, you know, challenges that come your way. But it's just that you have to kind of take it with a grain of salt, because it's like you're chasing your passion. You cannot really be picky about it. You cannot be like, ki, nah yaar, ye nahi karna, ye nahi karna. If you keep doing that, then you might find yourself not doing anything in the future, because it's like you've ran out of the period where people should be struggling because you were trying to be comfortable then. And now when you should have been comfortable, you don't have anything to last, anything to see you through, because it's like you didn't struggle in your struggling period. And every job, every profession has a struggling period. And the people that we look up to, you know, people that are killing it, be it musicians, actors, industrialists or business owners, they've all struggled. And some of the struggles that I've faced in my life as an artist are not getting paid on time, not getting paid enough, it's mostly money related. And I feel like a lot of that has to do with how people look at artists. People just tend to treat artists as like, you know, broke boys or whatever. I mean, it's like, it's not that. I mean, I have equipment that is like, you know, over 1 lakh, and that's all of my money, and I'm using that to translate your ideas. And you cannot ask me to use my equipment, my knowledge, you know, college is expensive, equipment is expensive, all of that. You cannot ask me to use all that I've put into being as good as I am or as good as whoever is, and not pay enough. You can never be like, no, that's too much money, because it's not. It's never too much money. It's something that a person has spent a lot of time deciding, ki, you know, haan, main itna charge karna chahta hoon. And I feel like ye theek hai. Koi bhi job ho, koi bhi gig ho, whatever your profession is, whatever you do, usme, if you're doing it as somebody who's an individual, as a freelancer, then there will always be dry spells. If somebody's watching and thinking, ki matlab, you know, I want to pursue this, you have to decide what's more important to you, so that it helps you improve what you do. So that it helps you be like, ki haan yaar, why not? Why can't I be so good that people are dying to work with me? And that should be ideally be the driving force. People should want to work with you. People should not seek you as a service. People should not come to you like, ki mujhe logo banwana hai. People should be like, mujhe ye logo isse banwana hai. And that is, I think, something that the youth or whoever is interested in this line of profession should think about. Ki like, what are you bringing new to the table? A lot of people in this generation just like to freestyle a lot. Ki matlab, theek hai, jo aayega wo karenge. But that is sort of letting your life take control of you, rather than it be the other way around. I feel like you should be in the driver's seat of life and not a passenger in the bus of life. When I was a kid, like when I was like, I think 4 or 5 years old, my father started calling me Lieutenant Peter D'Souza. I grew up and I started rapping a little bit. I mean, I rap about like silly stuff. So I decided to create a different persona that is more, you know, like into jazz-based hip-hop, sampling and, you know, lo-fi and all of that. So Peter D'Souza ka birth wahan hua tha, college final year, 2017. So I started learning how to produce music, how to, you know, flip samples and do stuff like that. Then I started moving to playing melodies. And right now, it's been almost one and a half years that I've been working on Peter D'Souza Sucks, which is the Peter D'Souza album that I'm working on. It mostly has to do with, like, you know, feelings of loneliness, depression and all of that. The album sees me through that whole conversion of, like, you know, from sad to happy. So there's a lot of infusions in the album going on also. Like, the album starts off at a low point. It goes to like a happy-ish sound and comes back to a sad sound and then ends at a neutral-ish sort of a sound. I'm singing on this now and that's new to me. I've never sang. Not sure, but I think I'll be releasing it in Feb, like mid-Feb, hopefully. My father's he's quite boss, actually. I mean, he's the guy that taught me self-defense. That's his business. He's a self-defense instructor. And, you know, he rides the bike faster than me. And he's fitter than me. I'm 23 and he's fitter than me at the age of 49. And I travel with him. I've been with him to Rajasthan, Spiti, Chandigarh. Might have gone to other places, I don't remember. But Spiti was one of the most exciting trips because it was just the two of us and it was right at the height of monsoon there. So there was a lot of rain, a lot of mud, a lot of like sliding, a lot of, you know, luckily I had just one fall. It wasn't nothing serious, but the whole trip with him, I just could see that there's, you know, a lot of things that I can learn from him. So Seethamoth contacted me to do their album art, I think earlier this year, in around February they contacted me. They said that they wanted my art. Both Encore and Calm had been looking at my work for a while and they were like, we have this album coming out and this is the idea that we have. We like the Dandi March statue and we want to do something like that. I said, that's cool. I mean, that works with me and let's do it. They had gone with a different album name first. It was called Kranti. When these guys contacted me, they said that, you know, we want these people on our album cover. And I was like, cool, let's do that then. I mean, it sounds interesting. They're like, we don't want it to exactly be like the Dandi Maa statue. We want it to be a little bit, you know, fun. Fun in a way, like, don't give us Indian clothes. I mean, have like a few influences of like different cultures. Maybe we could be wearing like some fly shoes and all of that, you know, some jewelry here and there. But it has to be kind of post-apocalyptic type. Matlab, Not destruction oriented, but it's just like ki it's a new uprising. Like after the world is, you know, like gone to the dogs, these guys are coming out with something new. So that's why I went with the color of the sky that's, you know, like that. And these guys are wearing something that is sort of Indian but sort of Roman, mixed here and there, with like some really cool shoes. So the thing that was quite interesting was that these guys sent me shoes that all of them had to wear. And that was like a nice little intro into like the whole shoe culture. I've never been into like shoes that much. I'm like, wow, these shoes are fucking expensive. I mean, like, you just want me to put them on your illustration? That's cool, I'll do that. So the areas that I got to play around with were, you know, the postures, a lot of them, because I got a lot of headshots for people. Ki matlab, this is what their faces look like, just put them on whatever sort of bodies. There's a lot of different body types, like, you know, Code on the cover is quite skinny, whereas Sez looks a little bit bulkier. Then there's Calm, who's a little bit crouched, and then there's Encore that's standing straight up. So it was like a anatomy masterclass or whatever. So this album cover took a while to complete, just because I was like, you know, doing a lot of other stuff also. And they had contacted me at a time which was really, really calm and really easy for them. They contacted me much in advance so that kuch changes ho ya kuch bhi kharabi ho, usko change karne ke liye kafi time ho. So that happened. Then once the album art was done, then I got in the loop with Mo and Uday. I've been talking to Mo primarily, And it was nice to see, you know, that sort of a reaction from him also, because I was only talking to these guys, like Seethamoth. And Seethamoth, I respect them a lot, and you know, but they're still my age, so it's like I cannot revere them how I would revere somebody that started a new thing like Azadi, like Mo. So talking to Mo and like hearing him, you know, be proud of the work that I've done was really cool. And yeah, I just hope that I get to do more stuff like this with more people like this in the future, because this is like, yeah, this is what I want to do, get into the music scene as a visual artist. My future plans are very, very structured, but I'm not strict about them. Ki nahi hua to nahi hua, iske liye ek saal aur hai, ya aise hai. So plan ye hai ki to work with like more musicians. I really want to, you know, see my art be on more album covers, probably get into film as an artist. I have one project that I'm working on right now, which is about the whole ordeal of sexting. I mean, it's something that's a very you know, integral part of our culture, I find, and I feel like I want to explore, you know, what I can do with the concept of sexting and the concept of those images and those texts that you get. So that is a series that I'm working on. Apart from that, I'm working on an album as Peter D'Souza. I've not been rapping for a while, so I don't know, that's kind of taken a backseat for now because I'm already focusing on a lot of things. So Peter D'Souza album is happening. Then I won the Royal Enfield Scramble. I finished second position in that. My teammate was my father, so that was really great. That was my first competitive motorcycling event, and finishing second in a event like that was a big deal for me because, you know, I've just been riding for a little bit over a year. But the next motorcycling event that's on my mind is the Sajoba Rally that happens in Punjab. And Sajoba ke baad Raid the Himalaya, which is the toughest rally in India, that happens in Himachal Pradesh. And yeah, so motorcycling, music, art, those are my three goals. And I think, like I said, the end goal is just being in at least one history book, if not more.